Hey guys, I'm Annabelle, and welcome to Meeple Village. Today we're going to be doing an unboxing of Unmatched. So join me at the table and let's find out what's in the box. Okay, so for those of you not familiar with Unmatched, it is a system with a lot of expansions out there already where you can mix and match characters from all the expansions and put two, I guess you can call them heroes, against each other. In this particular box, as you can tell, we're going to be having Medusa, King Arthur, Alice, and Sinbad. So four characters. I guess we shouldn't call them heroes because I don't know that Medusa was a hero, but four characters that can go at each other in this game. So that's the art in the front. Of course, we have our characters, a little bit of explanation in the back. It's basically a card game. We have asymmetrical powers because our deck is specific to each character. So each character is going to have its own specific deck that's going to be doing its own specific things. I kind of reminded me of Disney Villainous or Marvel Villainous, where, you know, everybody has, it's very asymmetrical and everybody has their own kind of flavor when they play, the way they do things. Just based on what I saw, the reviews that I saw, etc., that's kind of what it reminded me of, Disney Villains. But let's see what comes in the box. I know that there's miniatures to indicate who's your character, and then, well, a deck. In battle, there are no equals. Unmatched. Battle of Legends, Volume 1. These are the rules, and always such small booklet. Why can't you make me a bigger booklet? The box is big enough. But very colorful booklet. It's not that long, but of course the font is not big. It looks like there's no numbers, but you see that it's not that long. And there's an icon reference and then credits in the back. All right, next up we have what I'm guessing is health dials, just by the look of them. And then this must be a token, I think, for Alice. Big, would make sense for it to be Alice. Let's take a look at them a little closer. So it tells you how to assemble them, and then there's different colors for different characters. This is Alice, and everybody has apparently some kind of companion. There's Merlin, which I'm guessing maybe for King Arthur. We'll take a look in the back. There's the porter, okay, and Sinbad and Medusa. There's King Arthur, red, yeah, they look like Merlin. And then in the back, of course, they're just plain boring, but we have small. This is my first copy of Unmatched. I don't have any of the other boxes, although I did see characters like Bruce Lee and some characters from Jurassic Park. What else did I see? The Invisible Man. There's a lot more out there, but in this box, only those four characters. So if I am to make a playthrough of this, which I know I'm going to play it, but if you guys want to see a playthrough, then out of these four characters, which two would you like me to put against each other? Would it be Sinbad against Alice? Would it be Medusa against King Arthur? King Arthur against Alice? You guys go ahead and pick. Leave us a comment. So let's check out the game board. Okay, there we go. I see that there's, looks like a forest of some kind, or a city in ruins, and then there's a river that kind of cuts across, and this different color are different zones in the game. So all these red areas belong to the same zone, and all these purple areas belong to the same zone. So this area is pretty big. And this one that has three colors belongs to all three zones. So this is part of the yellow zone, the purplish pinkish zone, and the brown zone, all three. This green one is harder to come. It's the only green is here, blue here, etc., etc. And that's important for range attack because as far as I know, if you have a range attack, let's say you're standing here, you have range attack, you can target any other character that's on your zone. So if a character is here, you're standing here, he's on your zone because your zone shares the color with where the character is standing. You wouldn't be able to attack him here because, well, that's blue and you're standing on this purple area. And the board is also two-sided, which, you know, gives the game a little bit of replayability, a lot of replayability actually, because it's totally different on this side. The areas change completely. So that's kind of cool that they did that. That you have different ways of of playing the game even within the same box. Next up, I love the insert. I gotta say it's probably one of the best inserts I've seen. Everything is organized. Of course, there's a lot of lost space unless there's stuff underneath here, which now we see that there isn't. So they didn't need to make such a big box. But okay, I'll take it just because it's organized. And it even has everyone's name here. So we know that this is Alice stuff, Sinbad stuff, Medusa, and King Arthur. And you can keep it organized. Also, the miniatures have a nice place to put them. Of course, if you think about buying more expansions, and you're going to have a bunch of boxes with little things. Because I like to keep, once I buy an expansion, I try to keep everything in the same box if I can. I know you guys want to look at the miniatures, so let's take a look at those first. Here is King Arthur. Let's see if we can... I like that it's almost like it's primed to be painted, if you like to paint your miniatures. And if you don't like to paint your miniatures, he's still cool. I gotta say that this base is removable. Well, not with one hand. It's not. Yes, it is. So I guess... you don't have to have him be red all the time, although his deck I think is red. But for some reason it's removable. Might mean something in the future, I don't know. Next up we have the game's take on Alice. Because she definitely doesn't look like she came out of that fairy tale. It's not a children's Alice. But she does look like Alice. Here's Sinbad looking awesome with his swords. Very nice. Okay, good. And one more. This is probably my favorite of them all. I mean, the hair just... is it hair or the snakes? She's got her bow, which is pretty cool. Detail on the face, not that great, at least not on camera. But look at that. That's pretty cool. The snakes, the mouths. Yeah, that looks pretty amazing. All right, up next, of course, we have these things, which I love that they separated them. They have the male and female, and these are to put the dials together. I'm guessing that all of that stuff can be put underneath the box, and that's why they left the... although they have space here, but what is this for? All these tokens, probably. So these are probably just going to have to go down under the box. I don't think I need to open these. These are just the boring little things that you put... which one you put the dials together. Alright, next up we have tokens, and those, yes, let's take a closer look at those. Looks like we have three that are green, like Medusa's color, one orange, which is Sinbad's color, I believe, one red for the king, and one for Alice. First, these three green ones, which I believe are harpies, and they are kind of like Medusa's companions. There's three of them, all the same. King Arthur has this token, the same on both sides. It's probably to denote maybe where he's at on the board, although there's miniatures for that, so I'm not sure. This is for Sinbad, same art on both sides. And finally for Alice, maybe this is to denote their companions. I know they have a companion, each one of them you saw has a companion. And again, it's really nice that you can just go ahead and store those in their individual places. And they made this one a little deep, so that we can fit all of the harpies. And with that said, all we have left are we have a place to put their dials. We don't. That's, I mean, the insert. I gotta give them to them. They did a really good job with the insert. All right, let's take a look at all of our cards. I'm not gonna go through them in detail, but I will show you all of them. You can pause if you need to see them closer. I don't want to spoil too much of the game, not for you and not for myself, because I want to discover it as I play. But let's take a closer look at the cards. We're going to start with Sinbad, and you can see down here on the bottom, Sinbad and his sidekick, the porter. There is his card. He gets to move two. This is like his starting stats, I believe. Starting health, he's a melee hero, which means he can only attack from adjacent. This guy is also a melee hero. He has an ability. All right, moving on. He has these cards. And on the bottom, it tells you how many. So he has four toil and dagger and tells you what deck it belongs to, which, you know, the bag should also kind of give it away. Okay. Draw three cards. Okay. I'm just going to show you quickly. I love the art. It's kind of dark. It's really not cartoonish at all. Exploit. The art is pretty nice. There's three feints. One regroup. Two regroups. And three regroups. So that's Sinbad, and that's kind of the stuff that he can do. This is the bag for Alice and her psychic. Here are her stats. And her deck. Again, the art. Really liking the art. Drink me. So, of course, everything is going to be thematic and it's going to make sense for them. And that's, I think, the most appealing thing about this game is how do they make it so that it still works while keeping the theme, keeping everybody true to their theme and where they come from. And the good thing about this one, as opposed to Marvel Villainous or Disney Villainous, is that they're not like confined to just Disney, because isn't Alice from Disney? Think she is. So we got Disney and we got Disney Plus. This is the back of Medusa's and Harpy's deck. So you'll notice that Medusa has HP, but the Harpies do not. And that's different. All of everybody else has had HP. So there's our girl. Momentary glance, that eye. So I know that in this game, it's important to, hand management is really important, because if you run out of your deck, then what happens is you don't get to draw any more cards, you just start losing health instead. Whenever some effect asks you to draw cards, you start losing health. And of course, if you start losing health, well, you are out of the game and your opponent is the winner. So you want to be careful. You want to draw cards, obviously, because drawing cards is going to help you. But you also want to be careful not to draw too many, and then you start losing health. And the symbol up here, I'll explain it to you in a minute. This is, finally, King Arthur and Merlin's deck. And see, this guy has HP of 7, Merlin, and 18 for King Arthur. There's his ability and his movement. All right. And now this, so let me explain. I'm not sure what this 3 is. I don't remember. But I do know that this means attack. So these are multi-purpose cards. Either you use them for whatever is here, or you use them for the number up there. When you declare an attack, you're going to put a card face down and then reveal. Whoever has the biggest number is going to, of course, be the winner. Now, that's attack, but there are other cards that are for defense. I'm sure you're going to see them in a minute. I believe that number is a boost. So if you want to move, for example, King Arthur moves 2, but if you boost, if you discard this card, you can move an extra 3 spaces. I think that's how it works. Let's keep going, see if we can find any. There we go. There's a defense card. So attacker, obviously, is going to play the cards with the red attack symbol. Defense is going to play shield or this card. This card is actually both an attack and a shield. So you could play it during defense or you can play it during an attack. And if you're using the card for that, of course, you're going to not use it for this ability. So here's a straight up just defense card. This is a different symbol. I'm imagining it's some kind of ability that happens immediately. It's more defense. Of course, defense 0, that's not going to help much. So let's say that these are from 2 different players and they're attacking you for 4 and you defend for 0, you will suffer 4 damage. If you were defending for 1, then you will suffer 3 damage. It's whatever the difference is between your card and your opponent's card. Command the storms. He has a lot of these immediate effects. And also down here, it tells you what character can use this card. So this card can be used by both King Arthur and his sidekick. But there are cards that are specific, can only be used by King Arthur. So if they're attacking your sidekick and the card says King Arthur, your sidekick cannot defend with that card. But he has a lot of any cards. Let me go slow so you can see. Regroup. There's regroup. So for example, this card is an attack of 6, but it can only be done by King Arthur. So Merlin cannot use this attack card to attack. And of course, there might be more to the game. I haven't read the instructions yet. I'm just going by what I know already and just gave you an idea of what that is. If I got anything wrong and you know that it's wrong, please let me know in the comments below. I do believe that everything that I said is correct. The only thing I don't remember is that boost symbol. I don't remember that very well. But I'm thinking of doing a run through for this. So again, you know the characters. Let me know which two you'd like to see hand-in-hand combat. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, give us a thumbs up. Make sure you join the channel and also follow us on Instagram and on Twitter so you can see really cool pictures of your favorite board games. I will see you guys on the next video. But until then, may you play more games.